Music is what made me want to dance. I couldn't dance, I wouldn't want to dance if I didn't have music. And when I retired, the worst thing about retiring was that I couldn't listen to beautiful music and not want to dance. But all that changed when I started teaching.
Not so easy to dance with Susan Farrell, as well as not so easy to dance like Susan Farrell. They called her Little Susie, the youngest of three girls in a modest Cincinnati family. She never knew what to do with her long legs until she followed her sisters into a dance class. 5 days a week, she studied ballet at the local conservatory. A scout from New York City Ballet came to town, offering scholarships. She didn't choose her, but said, "If you're ever in New York, please drop by." She and her mother packed all their belongings into the family Chevy and drove off to the city of 1,000 aspiring dreamers and impossible arms. Susie held one thought only, to make herself good enough for the New York City Ballet. At 15, she was accepted as a student. At 16, she was a member of the corps. But to win the attention of the great George Balanchine was another matter. She kept up with him. He made things harder. She inhaled and kept going. Inspired, he created new dances that announced her to the world. She followed his lead and danced without fear. Balanchine's company was the center of American ballet, and she was the diamond in its crown. She danced every night, sometimes twice, and starred in 28 ballets. Her range, her long-limbed, elegant wildness. Ballet looked different now. Even young muses grow up and need to stand apart from their mentors. She left New York and danced with a company in Brussels. For 6 years, she captivated the capitals of Europe. But one night, she saw a performance by the New York City Ballet and wrote a letter to Mr. Balanchine. "Come home," he said. She had danced for 28 years. On her last night, the theater overflowed with cheers and flowers. It was an ending, but also a beginning.
I love teaching. To teach is another way of dancing.
She has her own company now, teaching them not just the famous steps, but the courage to own them.
The curtain opens. You get the nicest breeze on your skirt, and it's like, you know, a cloud. It's a great heavenly kind of feeling that you...
O body swayed to music, O brightening glance, how can we know the dancer from the dance?
First dance with Suzanne, she was, I don't know, 16, 17, and she was definitely the best. And I remember going to Balanchine and saying, there is a girl at the School of American Ballet, and she is terrific. And well, he had come and seen her already, you know, and next thing I know, she's in the company.
The first time I did a little bit of a solo and my name appeared in the newspaper, I thought that was maybe the highlight of my life at that point. And then those times, you know, it started happening more often. In 1965, when Mr. Balanchine said he wanted to do Don Quixote for me, a big full evening ballet, that was probably the turning point of my life as a professional dancer. Everything new that he did for me has a special place in my heart because there's no other reference. You have really nothing to go on, and it's like being in a room with dust and the choreographer asks something and you whip up this dust and after hours and days it becomes a ballet.
Every once in a while a certain dancer seems to be a conduit for something bigger than that. She was meant to dance. She was meant to dance.
I first became involved with Kennedy Center as a teacher in 1993 when the chairman then, Jim Wolfenson, asked me if I would be interested in starting a ballet program.
The Exploring Ballet program with Suzanne Farrell is a three-week program here at the Kennedy Center. Suzanne's a legend, and to be in that same room with her and to be studying with her and learning from her is that kind of passing of that baton from one generation to the next generation.
I say to them, we know what we can do, but we don't know all that we can do. So that's the focus of this program, is to explore. And when you explore, you discover.
Out of the success of the work that she was doing with that group of young dancers, the idea for the Suzanne Farrell Ballet Company sprang forth.
I believe in dance. It's a way of having an individual find out about themselves through how they express themselves through movement. It's natural to want to move and to express yourself through your body, through your movement. The body can't lie. You know, you can lie with words, but the body is honest unless you teach it to be wrong.
Suzanne's work here at the Kennedy Center has really been quite extraordinary. Over the past 10 years, the company has staged more than 40 ballets. She is so committed to her art. She is so committed to developing dancers and developing the company.
You get what you give, and she gives so much that it makes people want to give more to the company. And when you nail it, when you really help her get her vision, there's no better feeling in the whole world.
As a conductor for Suzanne Farrell, you're really a collaborative partner. She'll say, conduct it how you want. Conduct it musically and we'll dance to it. And that doesn't happen that often, because if you actually can control every aspect of things, people by human nature want to. And she does not want to control the music. She wants the music to be musical.
Suzanne has a way of pulling things out of you that nobody else can.
She doesn't expect us to be carbon copies of the person who did it before or herself. You know, she really works with us to make it our own and to be individuals.
Everything has a feeling. Every step has a meaning. And it's not just walking on the stage. There has to be something behind it.
She's probably the most giving director and teacher that I've ever worked with.
Her firsthand experience and knowledge and being able to communicate that and to teach others and pass it on is just so unique. it's wonderful to watch and it's wonderful to be a part of it.
If life were wonderful, we would all dance, we would all paint, we would all be musicians, we would all sing. But we need these things in our lives to remind us of how much more life we need.
Beautifully restored Rialto Square Theater in Joliet, Illinois. The Chicago City Ballet. Maria Tallchief, founder and artistic director. This evening's broadcast will feature two new ballets choreographed by co-artistic director Paul Mejia. First, Eight by Adler. Music by Richard Adler and especially arranged by him for the Chicago City Ballet and Suzanne Farrell, guest artist and principal ballerina of the New York City Ballet. Mr. Adler has included many of his most popular compositions in this arrangement, including Hey There, You Gotta Have Heart, Hernando's Hideaway, and Whatever Lola Wants. Eight by Adler, with Suzanne Farrell and the Chicago City Ballet.
Take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Hi, all. This is Kermit the Frog, and with me today is the world-famous ballerina, Miss Suzanne Farrell. And Miss Farrell is going to do 20, what is it you're going to do?
Grand battement.
Yes, of course. 20 grand battement.
Hello, Kermit.
Hi, Grover.
Hi, Suzanne.
Hi, Grover.
What you going to do?
Well, Suzanne is going to do 20 grand battement for
wow!
us.
Wow!
Would you like to show Grover what a grand battement is?
Yes.
Oh.
Woo! That was cute.
Isn't that neat?
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to do 20 of them, huh?
Sure.
Okay. Well, let's go. We'll count them.
One.
One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Wow.
Ten.
I'm getting dizzy.
11. 12. 13. 14.
15. 16. Can't you do it?
17.
Yes, she's going to do it.
18.
18.
19.
19.
20. Wow. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? That was just wonderful. Wonderful.
She even bows pretty.
Mm-hmm.